Spending time at the grill is a hallowed summer tradition, and so is enjoying the sizzling results on a roll. Consider for a moment the hamburger, that spheroid of summer goodness that practically drips red, white, and blue.
Juicy broiled hamburgers with just the right touch of charcoal flavor from the fire have become an American institution.
Indeed they have. So this is
the... Oh boy, we got some good stuff here. You've got a shack burger and I've got a smoke shack.
Just ask restaurateur Danny Meyer, the passionate palate behind the sensation Shake Shack.
It's the most democratic food that America has ever produced, at least for carnivores. Because it's kind of there for everybody all the time.
In fact, hamburgers are the most popular food in the country. On average, most of us down a burger once every 9 days.
Thank you very much.
Josh Ozersky might have downed a few more than that. He wrote the book on burgers, one of them at least, and he's proud to say that the U.S. can indeed take credit for inventing an icon.
So it's a purely American creation.
It's completely American.
Everything, this is ours.
Everything about its identity is American. Its birth is American. Its evolution is American. It's almost more American than America itself. I mean, it represents America to the world in a way that George Washington doesn't.
Had the burger been around then, there might have been grease stains on the Constitution. But as it turns out, most put the burger's birth around the late 1800s. Countless people claim to have created the very first one. After all, it's not exactly the space shuttle.
Hamburgers are not that complicated. But it really comes down to it's not rocket science.
But the Schnipper brothers, Jonathan and Andrew, burger chefs practically since birth, admit that simplicity can be a little deceiving.
There's definitely a lot of variables, like there's the beef to bun ratio, there's whether you put butter on the bun, there's, you know, how coarse you grind the meat, all that stuff. Right?
Absolutely. There are so many different styles of burger out there.
Everyone wants to say that they know what the best burger is, but it's a very personal experience, and that maybe is why burgers are so popular, because it's so personal to all of us.
One thing is certain. From its very inception, the burger was meant to be mobile.
Go and try to eat fried chicken while you're driving. You know what I mean?
Most credit White Castle as being the very first to realize the burger's takeout benefits. Folks like In-N-Out practically made the drive-in a religion. But it was McDonald's, of course, that made the burger ubiquitous. Even the hamburger's very ingredients became a national, mind-numbing jingle.
Two all beef patties, special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions on a sesame seed bun.
Danny Meyer is one of those helping lead a growing chorus to improve the burger. He offers a grass-fed, hormone- and antibiotic-free alternative, still served, though, with a hint of that drive-up nostalgia we all seem to crave.
This is basically just exchanging a park for a parking lot. It's about bringing people together.
Well, this is a far better burger than I've ever had sitting in my car, I will say that.
Thank you.
Without a doubt.
Good food is often about good memories. With the possible exception of a cold beer, the burger may just be the best food for your mood.
It just makes me so happy to see that there's this product that just, in an unmitigated way, brings joy to people.